Were you looking to learn some math? Well, then you are on the right channel. Hi everyone, welcome to Mathematically Inclined. And today we are discussing parametric differentiation. For the previous parts of this chapter and for the playlist of the other uploaded chapters, please do not forget to check the description box. And now, let's dive straight into the topic for the day. So for parametric differentiation, now, if you have, let's say, a variable x, which is a function of t, likewise, you have another variable y, which is a function of t once again, this t is known to be the parameter, and the challenge is to find this dy by dx in this case. Now, let's recollect your chain rule to do the same. So, if I begin with this y and we differentiate with respect to x, in this case, you get dy by dx is equal to, let's say we call the derivative of gt as g dash t. But since we have the parameter or the variable to be t and we are differentiating with respect to x, so that becomes dt by dx. Now let's check out what this dt by dx is going to be. For that, if you focus on x is equal to a function of t, and let's say we differentiate both sides with respect to x. So we get 1 is equal to f dash t into dt by dx. So from here, your dt by dx is equal to 1 over f dash t. Now simply substituting this value over here, you get g dash t into 1 upon f dash t. And this brings us to the final formula for dy by dx, which is g dash t by f dash t, or simply it is the same as saying dy by dt upon dx by dt. So for our examinations, we would just remember this formula and get going with the questions. So the formula is right here. You're given an example where x and y have been expressed in terms of the parameter t, and we need to find dy by dx. So once again, you mentioned the formula, and now to find your dx by dt, directly differentiate x with respect to t. So we get minus sine t plus half, derivative of log would be 1 upon tan square t by 2. Further, derivative for tan t by 2 whole square would become 2 tan t by 2. And derivative for tan is secant square t by 2, which further for t by 2 is half. So basically, we have used chain rule multiple times. In order to recollect the same, please check out the playlist on derivatives and find the video on product, quotient and chain rule. So in simplifying, I can cancel out 2 and 2 and I can cancel out tan t by 2. Now expressing this tan t by 1 upon tan t by 2 as sine t by 2 here and cos t by 2 goes up. Secant square t by 2 could be written as 1 upon cos square t by 2. So when you cancel these out, we are left with 1 upon 2 sine t by 2 cos t by 2 gives us sine t. Now taking the LCM, we get 1 minus sine squared t upon sine t, which gives us a cos square t sine t. So let's leave this here and pick up our y. Y gives us dy by dt as simply a cos t. Now let's substitute our dx by dt and dy by dt in the main formula. So we get a cos t on the top, and we have a cos square t upon sine t, which goes up. And the final answer is only tan t. So dy by dx in terms of the parameter is tan t. Now for question 2, we are given x and y once again in terms of a parameter, which is theta. Parameter is just like any variable. It could be represented by t, theta, x, y, z, anything. So let's begin by finding our dx by d theta. on differentiating this and applying the chain rule, this gives us 3 secant square theta. Further, the derivative for secant theta is secant theta tan theta. So this becomes 3a secant cube theta tan theta. Let's move to your dy by d theta, which is going to be a into 3 times tan square theta into, now derivative for tan theta is secant square theta. Now, you get dy by dx is equal to dy by d theta upon dx by d theta. So on substituting these values, you get 3a tan square theta sec square theta upon 3a secant cube theta into tan theta. So in simplifying, we are just left with tan theta upon secant theta, and thus our answer is only sine theta. Now, do not leave your answer here, because the question further says that find dy by dx when theta is pi by 3. So we say, therefore, dy by dx at theta equal to pi by 3 is sine of pi by 3, which we all know is root 3 by 2. We have yet another question, x and y in terms of theta, and we need to find dy by dx. So once again, this is going to be dy by d theta upon dx by d theta. Differentiating, let's say your x with respect to theta here. We have the product rule, derivative of e to the power theta is e to the power theta into second function as it is, plus the first function as it is into derivative of the second, which would be 1 minus 1 upon theta square. You can take your theta, e raised to power theta common, and we are left with theta plus 1 by theta plus 1 minus 1 upon theta square. Now, let's get straight to our y. Dy by d theta is, repeating the process, e raised to power minus theta would have the derivative as e to the power minus theta into minus 1, second function as it is, plus the first function as it is into derivative of the second. Taking e to the power minus theta common, we are left with minus theta plus 1 by theta plus 1 plus 1 upon theta squared. Now, on substituting both the values in dy by dx and taking LCM, this is the final answer. Looking at the fourth question, once again you have x and y in terms of t, and we need to find dy by dx. Rather, this time we need to prove dy by dx is a certain thing. Since you already see the presence of log in the function, what we can do is you can begin by taking log on both sides, which would just leave us with cos 2t here, because log e to the base e is just 1. Now, differentiating with respect to t, we get 1 over x into dx by dt is equal to minus 2 into sine 2t. So dx by dt becomes minus 2x sine 2t. Likewise for your y, if we take log on both sides and next we differentiate with respect to t, we get 1 upon y dy by dt is equal to 2 cos 2t. So our dy by dt is 2y cos 2t. Substituting dy by dt and dx by dt in dy by dx, this is what we obtain. So now, as you can see, these get cancelled. We already have minus y by x, and we had just noted that your cos 2t was nothing but log x and sine 2t was log y. So we replace them here and we say this is the final answer. I would recommend you people to pause the video and try out this question. Once you solve, please tally your answers. So dx by dt from here, we can apply our quotient rule. It becomes t square square, so that's t raised to power 4. Now derivative of 1 plus log t would just give us 1 by t into the denominator as it is minus numerator as it is into the derivative of denominator, that's 2t. So on simplifying, you get t minus 2t minus 2t log t upon t raised to power 4, which gives us, this one gives us only minus t. So now if we take minus t common, we are left with 1 plus 2 log t upon t raised to power 4, which gives us just minus of 1 plus 2 log t upon t cube. Similarly, your dy by dt would give us t square, and applying the quotient rule, this would be 2 by t into t as it is minus 3 plus 2 log t into derivative of your denominator, that's 1. On simplifying, this is what we obtain. And finally, on substituting the values for dy by dt and dx by dt, you would just be left with 1 upon t square upon 1 upon t cube, which would give us the answer t. Now look at the sixth question. We are given x and y in terms of theta, and you have to prove this huge statement. Do not worry, it is very simple. Beginning with our regular dy by dx, writing it as dy by d theta upon dx by d theta, let's try to directly differentiate and put in the formula along. So your dy by d theta would be n into secant raised to power n minus 1 theta into derivative of secant theta, which will be secant theta tan theta, n into cos raised to power n minus 1 theta into derivative of cos theta would be minus sine theta, so that makes it plus here. All upon derivative of x with respect to theta gives us secant theta tan theta, and this is just plus sine theta. So far this is what we get out of dy by dx. So the trick is you take tan theta common from your numerator and denominator. Rather, we can also take n common here. So I'm marking this as my star step. When you take n tan theta common from here, you're left with secant raised to power n theta. So we would end up getting plus cos raised to power n theta. And if you do not follow this, in order to take tan theta common from here, when there is actually no tan theta, we need to multiply and divide with tan theta. So this one, when we take common, you are only left with this part. Now this tan theta could be expressed as sine theta upon cos theta, which would lead us to only cos raised to power n theta. Likewise, tan theta from here gives us secant theta, and repeating the process of multiplying and dividing with tan theta, you are left with only cos theta. So this is what we get for our dy by dx. Now we are looking at dy by dx whole square. Let's square both sides. We'll be left with n square. This would give us secant raised to power 2n theta plus cos raised to power 2n theta. This would be plus 2ab, which gets cancelled, and we are only left with 2. Similarly, in the denominator, you get secant square theta plus cos square theta plus 2. My x square would be sec theta minus cos theta whole square. That gives us secant square theta plus cos square theta minus 2. So when you add 4 on both sides, this is what we end up getting. That means the denominator could be merely replaced by x square plus 4. Likewise, let's check out your y square. So y square gives us secant raised to power 2n theta plus cos raised to power 2n theta minus 2. Now, if I add 4 once again, you get secant raised to power 2 n theta plus cos raised to power 2 n theta plus 2, which if you identify is the numerator over here. So that means if I substitute the new values, my dy by dx whole square becomes n square into y square plus 4 upon x square plus 4. If you cross multiply this, that's exactly what we had to show. So this is the end of parametric differentiation. Please practice a lot of questions and come back with a feedback if you want more. If you like the video, do not forget to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. I'll see you with the next one. Until then, bye-bye.